Welcome to this spoken tutorial on Create Collections in DSpace. In this tutorial, we will learn to create a collection, edit a collection, authorize a person as collection administrator. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3 and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have installed DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Have administrator's authority in DSpace. Created a community and subcommunity. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. This tutorial assumes that you have done the immediate previous tutorial assignment in this series. If not, please do so before proceeding ahead. The metadata used in this tutorial is available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the file before practicing. Collections are hierarchically located below the community or subcommunity. Collections are nothing but containers for items. Items can only be submitted in the collections. A collection can be created by a DSpace administrator and community administrator. Now let us proceed to create a collection using DSpace administrator authority. Open a web browser and go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with an administrator account. I will log in with my administrator account. We are now in the admin's My DSpace page. Click on the Browse tab in the navigation bar. Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. All communities and subcommunities are displayed. Collections can only be created in the community or subcommunity. Let us select the subcommunity to create a collection. Under the IITB Digital Library community, I will select the Electrical Engineering subcommunity. The community homepage of Electrical Engineering is displayed. To create a new collection, click on the Create Collection button in the Admin Tools section. Describe the collection page opens. The workflow for item submissions in this collection can be configured in this page. The default workflow for item submissions is item submission without review. But for this demonstration, I will configure item submission with the review step. To do so, check the following option. The submission workflow will include an accept or reject or edit metadata step. Then, click the next button at the bottom right corner. The next step is describe the collection. In this step, we will submit the collection's metadata. Collections are described using metadata elements. Basic metadata elements of collections are name, short description, introductory text, copyright text, sidebar text, license, provenance, and logo. Switch back to DSpace. Notice that all the fields in the form are optional. But it is recommended to enter at least a collection name. Otherwise, an untitled collection will be created. For ease of practice, we have provided collection metadata in a text file. I will use the same for entering the collection metadata. Enter the name and introductory text as shown. I am naming the collection as Articles. You can use basic HTML tags in the introductory text field. For now, I will leave short description, copyright text, sidebar text, license and provenance as empty. Also, I will skip uploading a logo. Then click on the next button at the bottom right corner. We will be redirected to authorization to submit page. In this step, we will provide item submission authority to e-persons and groups. Click on the Select ePeople button to choose the e-person. A pop-up window, Select ePeople, opens up. Click on the Add button adjacent to the ID of the respective e-person. I am adding the user with email ID dspace.u5@gmail.com. Close the Select ePeople pop-up window by clicking on the Close button. Immediately, the selected user will be added to the authorized e-person list. If you wish to add more members, then repeat the same steps. Similarly, groups can also be authorized to submit items to collections. For this demonstration, I will skip group authorization. Then click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. Next step is Submission Workflow Accept, Reject, Edit Metadata step. In this step, we can authorize e-persons and groups to review items. Reviewers are permitted to edit the metadata of incoming submissions. Also, reviewers can accept or reject submitted items. To add an e-person, follow the same steps which are used to assign submit authorizations. I will assign reviewer authority to the e-person with email ID dspace.u4@gmail.com. Then click on the Next button at the bottom right corner. We are redirected to the Edit Collection page. This page has the details of the newly created collection. So we have now successfully created a collection. Let us proceed to cross-verify this collection. To do so, click on the Home tab in the navigation bar. Now click on the Browse tab in the navigation bar. Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. The Communities and Collections interface appears. Observe that the newly created collection Articles is displayed under the subcommunity. Now, let us proceed to edit the collection. Click on the collection name to select it for editing. The collection homepage opens up. Next to the collection homepage section, we have admin tools. Admin tools are used for managing the collection. To edit the collection, click on the Edit button in the Admin Tools section. Edit Collection page opens with details of the selected collection. Now edit the fields in the collection's metadata form. I have updated introductory text as shown here. Once the metadata is edited, click on the Update button at the bottom of the page. Observe that introductory text is now updated. Now, let us proceed to learn how to delete the collection. To do so, first click the Edit button in Admin Tools. Then click on the Delete This Collection button above the Submission Workflow section. Immediately, you will be asked to confirm the Delete Collection action. To confirm, click on the Delete button. Once you click the Delete button, the collection will be deleted. For this demonstration, I will not delete the collection. So click on the Cancel button. We are back on the collection homepage. Now, let us proceed to assign a collection administrator for our collection. To do so, click on the Edit button in Admin Tools. The submission workflow section has settings for the collection administrator. Click on the Create button located next to the collection administrator. We will be redirected to the Edit Group page. Notice that this Edit Group page is the one which we used earlier to create a group. That means DSpace is creating a group of collection administrators. By default, DSpace generates a name for the group. But we can provide our own new name to the group of collection administrators. For this demonstration, I will keep the default name as it is. Collection administrator roles can be assigned to e-person and group members. Now, let us select an e-person to authorize as a collection administrator. To do so, repeat the same steps which were used to add e-person as submitter and reviewer. I will assign the collection administrator role to the e-person with email ID dspace.u3@gmail.com. Once done, click on the Update Group button at the bottom of the page to update the changes. We have now successfully assigned the collection administrator role to the e-person. Similarly, submission workflow can be used to edit submitter and reviewer. Let us proceed to cross-verify the newly assigned collection administrator role. Click on the Content tab in the navigation bar. Select Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Select the collection. I am selecting Articles. The collection homepage appears. Here, click on the Edit button in Admin Tools. Then click on the Edit button next to Collection Administrators. We can see that the e-person has been assigned the Collection Administrator's role. Now, the Collection Administrator has authority to manage this collection. Let us now log out this user from the DSpace interface. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to create a collection, edit a collection, and authorize an e-person as collections administrator. As an assignment, create a collection named Computer Engineering under IITB Archives Community. Assign a collection administrator to Computer Engineering Collection. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. The script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Varkey signing off. Thanks for joining.